I think good ideas often come from failure. Failure is just part of success. Maybe the more interesting finding is actually going to be something that comes out of that failure.
I love the excitement that comes from generating a new knowledge that were unpredictable when we designed the study.
Being a scientist, I have the luxury of being constantly surprised. We are pushed to come up with new ideas and hypotheses to test all the time.
My name is Laura Duvall. I'm a postdoctoral fellow at the Rockefeller University, and I study innate behaviors in mosquitoes. My postdoctoral mentor, Leslie Vossel, who was actually a 2007 winner of the Blavatnik Regional Award, working with her has really given me the confidence to take on totally new areas of research. So the work that I've been doing has been focused on identifying ways that these mosquitoes regulate their behavior. The two behaviors that I've focused on are how mosquitoes regulate their attraction to find and bite humans, and how female mosquitoes regulate their willingness to mate with a male. And in both of these cases, we've identified receptor signaling pathways that are important in the mosquitoes, and we've found drugs and genetic interventions to kind of disrupt these pathways. If we can find ways to turn these pathways on and off, then we can potentially find ways to get hungry mosquitoes to act like they've already fed on a human and lose interest in biting them. Or we can get a female mosquito to act like she's already had a mate and lose interest in mating with any more males. If we can find ways to prevent them from interacting with people, we could potentially prevent all of the diseases that these animals spread, things like dengue and Zika. One of the things that was very exciting about moving to mosquitoes, it really is kind of the Wild West. Not only do you have to figure out which research questions you're interested in, you have to figure out how to build the tools to answer those questions. I'm about to start my own laboratory at Columbia University, and so this award from the Blavatnik Family Foundation is really a big encouragement to get me to pursue the more innovative and riskier directions that I've been thinking about for my research.
My name is Carla Nasca, molecular neuroscientist at Rockefeller University and a former postdoctoral fellow of the American Foundation for Suicide Prevention. Major depression is a leading cause of disability worldwide. Existing antidepressants work too slowly or do not work on everyone who takes them. My contribution to this need for better antidepressants was with the discovery that acetyl-L-Carnitine, or LAC, can exert rapid antidepressant effects by turning genes on and off that are specifically related to the glutamate system. Glutamate is the main excitatory neurotransmitter in our brain. It was known that targeting the glutamatergic system with other drugs like ketamine can lead to rapid effects. We can achieve these same rapid effects with acetyl-L-Carnitine, opening the possibility to develop safer antidepressants. Our translational work showed that patients suffering from major depression produce less acetyl-L-Carnitine compared to healthy controls. This can lead to treat depression in a way that we didn't think about before.
I'm Liling Wan. I'm a postdoc fellow at the Rockefeller University. I study how cancer cells alter the gene expression program and also how we can reprogram the cancer cells back to normal to stop cancer cells from growing. I'm in particular interested in one area called epigenetics regulation, which is broadly defined as how the cells alter their gene expression without changing the underlying DNA. We discover a previous unknown function of a protein that is involved in epigenetic regulation. We found that this protein has the ability to activate cancer-causing genes. Our discovery advanced our understanding of how abnormal gene regulation occurs in cancer, and at the same time, it opened up new avenue for us to really come up with potentially more effective cancer therapy to treat a particular cancer type such as aggressive leukemias.
We are generating an amazing amount of data, and so in these years I'm challenging myself with machine learning techniques, machine learning methods to be able to analyze this data in a way to answer important questions.
I'm where I am because of my mentors and role models. I will be starting my own research lab at University of Pennsylvania in 2020. This is really exciting moments for me, looking forward to continue to make major discoveries in my own lab, but at the same time, cultivating and educating a new generation of scientists through my own mentorship.